Assalamu alaikum viewers, please like, share and subscribe this channel. Links of PDF files used in this video are given in description. So today we shall study the second thermobalance, which is called as Aminco Thermobalance, and this part of the lecture belongs to the main topic of thermal methods of analysis. So in the last lecture we have discussed about the Chavignard balance, and we have seen that Chavignard balance is not so much robust balance, as there are many factors which affect the performance of the balance. Such as the biggest disadvantage of Chavignard balance was that it was exposed in the environment, and any air currents or the movements due to the gravitational movements of the earth, they can cause differences in the readings of the particular analysis. So we have shifted towards the more robust balance. This balance is called as Aminco Thermobalance, and it has more sophisticated mechanism, and this mechanism is such that the there is a very less variation in the readings. So we will see in the next part of this lecture that how this Aminco balance works. So first of all, we see the major outline of this thermobalance. So if we see here, so this is a quartz container, and in this quartz container or quartz housing, the sample container is hanged with the wall of this housing, and this blue cone is actually the sample holder or sample container, and it contains the sample about which we need to have analytical information. So this quartz housing is placed inside the furnace, so this whole heating area supplies the heat energy to the sample. Now this sample container is hanged with the ceiling of this housing through a spring, and this spring is placed in a magnetic field. So if we see here, this here spring or coil makes an armature coil, and this act like a small transformer or transducer, and if we move this spring up or below in this magnetic field, then it will produce a corresponding current. So as a spring moves in this area, the corresponding coil moves in a magnetic field, and as a result of which a current is produced. That corresponding amount of current is fed to the XY chart recorder, which will then make a graph. Similarly, the heating information is sent to the temperature control, and this is further then connected to the XY chart recorder. So there is a two type of information that this XY chart recorder records. First information that is coming from the furnace, this information is about the temperature, that how much temperature is fed to the furnace, and the information from the current generated, that is directly proportional to the weight change in the sample. So these two type of information is then compiled in the form of a graph, and this graph, as we know, is called as a thermogram. So as the heating furnace starts heating the our sample, so there is normally a reduction in weight. So due to the weight reduction, the spring moves upwards, and when it moves upwards, then a corresponding current is produced. That current is fed to the XY chart recorder, and similarly at that instant, the information at that weight change is provided to the XY recorder through this temperature control, and then a corresponding thermogram is produced. So in this way, this movement of the coil is corresponds to the weight change, and this mechanism is more sophisticated as compared to the weight change mechanism that we have already used in the Chavignard balance. So due to this protective housing or quartz housing, there is no gravitational movement that reaches to the sample container, and similarly the information is not disturbed by the air currents. So this is the more sophisticated, more robust mechanism as compared to the Chavinard balance. However, Chavinard balance was the start of the instrumentation of TGA, whereas the Aminco balance is the more robust instrument, and it has more sophisticated mechanism that reduces so many variations as compared to the Chavinard balance. However, apart from this robust information, there are two types of factors that can create a variation in the readings of a particular single sample. So there are two types of factors. One type is factors concerned with the instrument, and second type is factors concerned with the sample. Remember that these are two factors that if we take a reading of a single sample, then it can have variations in that analysis, and these are two factors which control those variations. So the variations due to the instrumental factors include the variations due to sample holder, due to the furnace and recorder of the balance, due to the shape of the furnace, due to the location of a sample holder inside the furnace, heating rate at which we are heating from 0 to 500 or 1000 and which increments of heating we are using. Similarly, geometry of the sample holder, then the furnace atmosphere, sensitivity and the placement of a thermocouple, stability of the power supply unit, sensitivity of the recorder and calibration of the balance. So these are two factors which can cause variations in the analysis of a single sample, and if we take second or third time the reading of a same sample, then it can have a variation. The factors concerned with the sample itself, that include nature of the sample, quantity of the sample, its physical state, its particular size, solubility of the evolved gases, heat of decomposition, sample packing and thermal conductivity of the sample. So this was all about today's lecture, which was about Aminco balance. I hope you have well understood this lecture. If you have any question, let me know in the comment section. I will reply as soon as possible. Okay, thank you. Allah Hafiz.